Australia has now decided to take the wine dispute with China to the World Trade Organization. It will be filing a formal complaint over China's imposition of those anti-dumping duties on Australian wine exports. Now, this is a dispute that has gone on for months now. What compelled Australia to take this decision now?
Well, we tried to resolve this using diplomatic means. We had our officials discuss this issue with Chinese officials, but ultimately we weren't able to resolve it. So we've taken the next step, and that's to go to the WTO. As you know, the WTO is there for all members where there are trade disputes, to be able to use the dispute resolution mechanism to try and resolve disputes. We're currently trying to do it through the WTO when it comes to barley and the imposition of tariffs that were put on barley and other restrictions. And now we're looking to do the same when it comes to wine. And this is a normal process that all countries used to try and resolve disputes, including China itself.
How soon do we expect that formal complaint to be filed? What will it say, and what are your expectations at this point?
Well, it will be filed straight away, and our expectations are that we would hope to be able to resolve this dispute before having to go through the full process of the WTO dispute settlement mechanism. That can take anywhere between 2 and 4 years. And our hope is that the Chinese government will be able to sit down with the Australian government and work through this issue, and we can resolve it before then. But if not, we will continue the full process because we think that we have a very strong legal case that the duties that have been put in place, anywhere between 116% to 218%, are causing harm and injury and are unwarranted.
Right. Australia has been walking a tightrope between balancing the security ties with the United States and the trade relationship with China. How concerned are you about this price that Australia is paying for being caught between these two countries?
Well, we want to have constructive engagement with China, and we've said that all along. When I became Trade Minister just before Christmas, at the same time as my counterpart was made Trade Minister, I wrote to my Chinese counterpart saying I'd like to sit down and work through the issues that we're currently facing. We mightn't agree on everything, but we could agree to disagree on certain things and hopefully resolve some of the other disputes that we've had. Now, I haven't had a response to that letter yet, and you know, we then have just decided, well, what we need to do is just make sure that we continue to engage right across the globe, make sure that we're diversifying our exports and send a clear message to China that when they're ready, we're happy to sit down and work through these issues, and that's what we'll continue to do. We've always made it clear we would never trade away our values, and we wouldn't trade away the very strong partnerships, security partnerships we have, like the relationship, the security relationship we have with the US and with other allies in the Indo-Pacific.
The Australian government has chosen to remain firm about seeking an inquiry into the origin of the COVID-19 pandemic as well, in spite of the economic costs. So will that push continue?
Well, we always have thought that it is incredibly important, not only for Australia, but for the rest of the world, that we know the origins of the coronavirus, and also that we learn from an investigation into the origins so that we can deal with future outbreaks swiftly and quickly, so they don't have the devastating impacts that the coronavirus has had on the global economy and on lives globally. It's had an enormous impact. You look at the impact that it's had on India. You look at the impact that it's had here in Australia. We want to make sure that a pandemic like we've seen over the last 14 to 15 months doesn't occur again.
Let's talk about the Australian-Indian Economic Strategy 2035, which talks about deepening trade ties with India. What kind of significance does Canberra attach to the India-Australia trade and investment relationship?
Oh, incredibly important. We've always thought that there are huge opportunities to advance the economic relationship between Australia and India. We have a substantial economic relationship, but we could do a lot more. And that's why the strategy is so important, and it's why I think we need to be doing more when it comes to a potential free trade agreement between Australia and India. There's enormous potential. There's the opportunity, I think, for further Australia investment in India, and there's also the potential for Indian investment in Australia, and two-way goods exchange could continue to grow and be enhanced. So I think it's an uncapped potential that the Australia-India economic relationship has. And my discussions with Minister Goyal, I know he sees the mutual benefits that could accrue from us strengthening the relationship. And now it's just a matter of us doing the hard work to try and make that a reality.
Do we expect discussions on the India-Australia Free Trade Agreement to now gather momentum?
Look, that would be my hope. I had a very positive discussion with Minister Goyal 2 months ago about our economic relationship. Obviously, in India, the focus rightly has been dealing with the coronavirus, but I'm looking forward to having further discussions with Minister Goyal. I said to Minister Goyal that I would send him a proposal as to how we could strengthen the economic relationship, and that proposal will be on its way very shortly, and I look forward to discussing it with him further when we get the time in the coming months.
Right. What kind of support is the Australian side willing to offer for the Indian proposal on the COVID-19 vaccine patent waiver?
Look, we've said all along that we're prepared to look at a vaccine waiver, and we've been playing a very constructive role in Geneva at the World Trade Organization on trying to get a breakthrough when it comes to how we can increase the amount of vaccines that are being manufactured globally. We see this as vitally important. Our Prime Minister warmly welcomed the decision by the US government to look at a waiver when it comes to the COVID-19 vaccine. So we want to play a very constructive role in this area because we understand how fundamentally important it is to all countries that we can ramp up the manufacture of COVID-19 vaccines and make sure they're distributed right across the globe, because we're not safe until everyone is vaccinated.
Dan Tehun, thanks very much for joining us here on We On World is One and sharing your time and perspectives.
Been a pleasure. Thank you, Molly.
We On now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.